Hello there. In this video, I'm going to walk you through a custom report that uses a formula field. And in this particular example, I'm going to use the formula field to have buckets where I can group contacts by how many marketing emails they've opened. For example, in bucket zero, this is contacts who have opened 1 to 9 marketing emails. In bucket one, they've opened from 10 to 19. From bucket two, they've opened 20 to 29. Bucket three, they've opened 30 to 39. Okay, so you get the idea. Here we go, so you can see how that's working. All right, now to do that, I'm going to use a formula field. I'll walk you through that. Formula fields, they've been around for a couple of months. There was a public beta rolled out at the end of September, so you can enable that in your portal. And I'll walk you through how the formula field works. So, by the way, I will just mention sometimes people, you've been able to do this before using calculated properties. You don't need that in this case. For example, people would have calculated properties where they'll just use a formula there, store it against the contact. And that's actually still quite handy for other reasons. You might want to build lists, etc., or trigger workflows on that kind of stuff. So that's all valid, but I'm not using that here. Okay, you don't need it here. The other thing is you don't need Operations Hub Enterprise for this. Operations Hub Enterprise is nice because it can actually give you formulas. That would make things a lot easier. For example, I'd probably use the floor formula function or things like that. But because I don't have Operations Hub Enterprise, I'm going to have to work out another way. And really, the trick is just to use the mod operator. So I'm going to talk about what the mod operator is. And you might want to tune out at this point if you're not interested, and I'll call you back in a little while. But let me remind you, what the mod operator means is it gives you the remainder if you divide by something. So 34 mod 10, the remainder is 4. So 34 mod 10 is 4, because you're essentially going 34 divided by 10, oh, that's 3, but the remainder is 4. Now, if you know that, you can go, oh, okay, why don't I then just go 34 minus 4, that's 30, divided by 10, that's 3. Oh, great, puts me in bucket 3. That's exactly what we're doing. We're just saying how many opens did they have minus that mod 10 and then divide by 10. All right, so let's say they had 34 opens minus the mod 10 minus the 4. So 34 minus 4 is 30, divided by 10 is 3. Great, that puts it into bucket 3. I'll go through next. And just this setting, I keep no value as is. I don't want to treat it as zero, just so that it puts those contacts that don't have a marketing, have had no marketing emails, it puts them right at the end here. And that's not necessarily a bad thing. Maybe they're not set up as marketing contacts. Maybe only sending sequences. Maybe they're phone calls. Maybe they don't even have an email address. Doesn't really matter. Let's get them out of it. And then that's what we have here. So that's the formula field. And then we've really just got two things. We've got our x-axis, which is that formula field, and then we're just putting a count of contacts on the y-axis. You can actually do other things, like why don't we break down by life cycle stage. Let me show you this, and let me see, it'll probably make me want to change the chart settings. That'll refresh. Oh, that's nice. But in case it broke that out, you might just want to come and put this stacked on, because sometimes that doesn't have that by default, and then you can kind of see a breakdown of those and at various places. So you might expect to see the lifecycle stage mix change based on which the bucket they're in. Let me take that out, come back here and just explain some of these buckets, because there is one thing I need to highlight, which is it doesn't include every grouping because it only includes the groupings that have contacts in it. That's why it jumps from 19 to 23. And even up here, you've got 86. Big outlier there. Let's kind of go to the end. One person was in bucket 86, which means one sad individual has opened between 860 and 869 marketing emails. Who is this? Well, yeah, of course, that's me. So there's something wrong where surely that I'm reading so many of my own marketing emails. That's a topic for another day. But that's the summary of the report. Basically, we're using formula fields. We don't need Marketing Hub. We don't need Operations Hub Enterprise. We're not using a calculated property that's on the contact. We're just using formula fields, and the mod operator is your friend.